afternoon in old Manhattan, and most folks are going home from work to their supper that their wives had prepared for them. But when the Kingfish got home tonight, there wasn't no supper ready. And believe me, he was really put out about it.
And in the future, when I come home, I expect to find you here with my supper ready. Keep your big mouth shut. You listen to me. I tell you, you try a trick like this again, and I'll walk out of here so fast it'll make your head swim. You understand? And that's what I'm going to tell her as soon as she gets here. Yeah, I want to tell you something.
Yes? What is it?
Good evening, honey.
I certainly am tired.
Did you been somewhere, honey lamb? Has you been somewhere, honey?
If it's any of your business, I've been to a meeting of the women's club. And after the meeting, I went home with Miss Winslow. She's one of our new members.
Now, see here, Sapphire. You're spending too much time with those old hens. Your face is here cooking supper.
Miss Winslow has such a lovely character.
What do I care?
She's got such a charming personality.
Look, I don't want you to have nothing to do with her, personality or not.
And she's just come into $20,000.
When can I meet this charming creature? You say she just come in to $20,000?
Yes. The story's in the evening paper. She inherited the money from an uncle. The paper's on the coffee table. It's right there in the second section.
This is Andrew H. Brown. Come out in, Kingfish. You know, Andy, I've been thinking about you, son.
Yeah? Well, it usually costs me money when you do that.
No, Andy, I was just thinking about how lonesome you are, brother dear. Son, you ought to get yourself married.
To a woman?
Well, it's customary when a man marries to nuptialize himself up with one of the neuter gender of the opposite sex, and I got just a gal in mind. She's nice. A middle-aged woman.
Kingfish, I don't want to marry no middle-aged woman.
No, no, Andy, that's just the kind. That's just the kind to marry. When a woman reaches middle age, she just enters into the gentle and romantic era of her life. That wonderful loveliness that only comes with approaching middle age. I tell you, Andy, when it comes to companionship, there's nothing nicer than a woman who is around 60 and sweet.
Yeah, but when it comes to smooching, I'd rather stick to the kind that's 19 and nasty.
I got just a woman for you, Andy, a Mrs. Elizabeth Winslow. Keep your eyes upon that lovely creature.
Holy mackerel, Kingfish, what a toad.
Well, it's my privilege to inform you that that toad is worth in the neighborhood of $5,000 a wart.
Say, Kingfish, what is that financial remark you dropped in the conversation?
Andy, there's more to man this gal than meets the human eye. Andy, has you ever known the warmth and the companionship of $20,000?
$20,000. You know, Kingfish, she done got awful put in the last few seconds.
Yeah, would you be interested in a gal like that, Andy?
Me interested in a gal just because she's got $20,000? When can I meet her?
Now you're talking, son. But remember, Andy, when you marry a gal, I get the usual introduction fee, 35% of the cheque. As I was saying, 40% of the take.
Come on, Kingfish. Let's go out and get a cup of coffee to celebrate my engagement.
But, Andy, don't you think it would cut down on the traffic if you moved that bureau down there?
No, it's better the way it is. Come on.
happiness despite it.
Yeah. Well, not to throw a wet blanket on things, but you know, I don't like the sound of this, Andy. You marrying a girl just because she got money. After all, in marriage, money ain't everything.
Yes, Amy, it may not be everything, but adding money to marriage is like putting orange juice in castor oil. It makes the whole mess a whole lot easier to take.
Well, of course, it ain't none of my business. I just hope you're going to be happy, son.
Don't worry about me. The Kingfish is going to have Sapphire introduce me to the gal.
Well, what makes you so sure this girl going to like you?
Like me? Listen, Amos, down at the pool hall, they don't call me Passion Flower for nothing. Well, listen, honey, why won't you introduce Andy to Mrs. Winslow? Now, give me one good reason.
Because Andy Brown is a no-good loafer. And since that article come out in the paper, Miss Winslow's got all kinds of suitors. You must be crazy to think that a woman with the money that Miss Winslow's got would be interested in anybody like Andy Brown.
Well, I never looked at it like that.
You can help me with the dishes. Why, you read about it in the society column every day, where women with as much money as Mrs. Winslow has could buy themselves a European title.
A title. Buy herself a title. A title. Well, the first thing in the morning, I think I'll go over and have a talk with Baron Brown.
Well, the next morning, with lightning's help, the Kingfish really went to work on Baron Brown. Yeah, sir, for once, lightning was really living up to his name. Oops, here he come again. The lily is really being guilty.
Well, lightning done brought the geranium, Andy.
Yeah, how do I look?
Hey, you look like something out of that big operetta, the stupid prince.
You say when I meet this Mrs. Winslow that I'm supposed to be a baron from Austria?
That's right, Andy. You're right off the boat from Vienna.
Okay, Kingfish, all set.
My privilege. Allow me, Baron.
Yeah.
Make way for the Baron.
The coat, Andy.
Listen, Kingfish, I can't go through with this. I'm too nervous.
Take it easy, Andy. We got $20,000 tied up here.
But Kingfish, he ain't gonna think I know Baron.
Oh, Andy, this gal is from the stick someplace. She ain't gonna know what's happening. All you gotta do is drop a few German words like Lieber Augustine and Wiener Schnitzel and stuff like that.
Well, you done told her we was coming, Kingfish?
Oh, yeah. I done called up and give you a big build-up, son. A big build-up.
Well, I hope she don't look as bad as a picture. That's all I got to say.
By the way, Andy, in society, we run up against an object that will provoke boisterous laughter.
Oh,
But common politeness dictates that you do not laugh in the object's face.
Yeah.
According to Emily Post, you giggle into a handkerchief.
Yeah.
Oh, why, Mr. Stevens, won't you come in?
I hope you haven't brought a handkerchief.
Mrs. Winslow, it's my privilege to present to you that famous nobleman from Europe and the continent, Baron von Braunspiegel.
Oh, how do you do, Baron? It is a pleasure to meet such a distinguished-looking man.
Likewise.
I took the liberty of having some tea made. Won't you sit down?
Listen to that. A jingle like that would make you independent for life.
Gentlemen, won't you be seated? And now, Baron, tell me, just what made you decide to leave Vienna?
Well, there was nothing left to do. You see, I never could get along very well with them foreigners.
Foreigners?
Oh, you see, what the band means is, although he's a genuine dyed-in-the-wool Austrian baron, he's also a neutralized American.
Oh, I guess that's why you speak such good English, Baron.
Oh, yeah. Actually, my father was a beauty pedestrian, but my mother was born right here on the old sod. So I didn't have no trouble losing my German brogue or something like that.
Oh, yeah. Like all Europeans, the Baron family was pretty well spread out.
Especially my mama.
Well, speaking of marrying Miss Winslow, like we was doing, the Baron informed me that he's looking for a little baronet to take back in the old country to share his ancestral chapeau.
Well, I hope you find the right girl, Baron.
Well, confidentially, the reason why the Baron is up here, he done seen your picture in the newspaper.
Oh. What does he think of me?
Well, he mumbled a few words in his native tongue, then he there shot up in the air like a German shepherd.
Oh, Baron, you European men are so charming. So perfect. And it's fine.
Ain't it the truth?
You want another cake, Baron? Oh, Mr. Stevens, I never thank you enough for bringing the Baron up today. He is just too wonderful.
Well, I can tell that the Baron thinks you are charming, too. It ain't often that he condescends to mingle with hoi polluted. Well, I'll be running along because I know you and the band got a lot of things to talk about.
Oh, Mr. Stevens, must you be going?
Well, according to the old slogan, three of the crowd. And I wouldn't want to interrupt any little love talk that you and the band has in regard to finances or nothing. Oh, no. Never mind waddling to the door. I can find my own way out. Good day, Baron.
And a good one to you, too.
Goodbye, Mr. Stevens.
Well, toodaloo, all.
Oh, Baron, tell me all about yourself. I know you had some wonderful, wonderful adventures.
Oh, yeah. I'll never forget the time when I was in Hamburg and I was strolling down the route in the city and I met the king of Sweden. And he came to Sweden. Baron, says, how do you do? I said to him, how do you do, king? He said,
here we go. Dinner with Mrs. Winslow. Well, talk about your courtships of Miles Standish. It had nothing on the courtship of Andrew H. Brown. Yes, sir, Andy really played the part of a suave continental lover to perfection. Well, almost to perfection. And the next thing in order was picnic with Elizabeth. Yes, as with all lovers, there was dancing in the dark, moonlight walks, picnics, and rides in the country. Needless to say, all this activity made quite an impression on Mrs. Winslow. And needless to say, Mrs. Winslow made quite an impression on the car. Now the boy is really closing in. And then come the fatal evening when our gallant lover popped the question.
Oh.
Bill. The Kingfish, it's all set. The wedding takes place at high noon on Tuesday.
Well, congratulations. Yeah. I'm glad you're figuring on a quick wedding. Otherwise, you're going to have creditors for flower girls.
Yeah, maybe the thing to do is to have the wedding down in the bank vault. Say, where's Amos? I got to tell him the news. He thought I couldn't pull this thing off.
Oh, he's out with a taxi cab somewhere. But I got to hand it to you, Baron. This proves that you are the lover boy of all time. 20,000 smackers.
Yeah. I think you'll find this be a nice rooming house, mister.
Yeah.
The elite restaurant is down on the corner there. A lot of the fellas eat there. Pretty nice, too.
Well, thanks for it. How much do you?
Half a dollar and a quarter from the boulevard.
All right, here you are. Keep the change.
Thank you. You seen him down long, mister?
Well, that depends. I'm looking up someone I haven't seen in a long, long time. It's my wife. You see, I left her 15 years ago.
Oh, yeah?
But this is enough to bring any husband back.
Did you know where he is?
Yeah, I know where he is.
Well, Lightning, where did he go?
Where did who go?
Andy and the Kingfish.
Oh, them. They went over to the Eli Vineyard to get some breakfast.
Oh, yeah, Kingfish. 2 days from now, me and Miss Winslow wander down the aisle together.
Yeah, they call for a little ham and eggs.
Oh, yeah.
Well, the joint kind of crowded, Andy.
Yes, it is. They had a table over in the corner with a couple of empty seats.
Yeah. Do you mind if we sit here, mister?
No.
Thank you.
Yeah, it is all right.
Double order, ham and eggs.
I think after the wedding, I'm going on a steady diet of filet mignon.
You would have to excuse my friend here. He's getting himself inoculated up.
Oh. Yeah, but confidentially, mister, the old goat eyes man is loaded with money.
Well, that makes it nice.
Yeah, but me and my friend here are really going to take that gal for a ride.
Oh, yeah. We're going to live off the fat of the land. Yes, yes. Mister, the wedding is all set for Tuesday, and me and my friend start going through our money from there.
excuse me, I'll be back in a minute.
Don't be long, Kingfish. Yes.
Excuse me, mister.
think we better sit down. This here problem is wearing out my rug.
I tell you, Calhoun, me and Andy going in debt. We got over $1,500 in bills. Andy just got to marry this gal.
Now, listen, fellas.
You shut up.
Calhoun, we got to find some way to eliminate this other fella. Now, what must we do?
Calm down, fellas. Calm down. The thing to do is see which way the wind is blowing. I tell you, I'll get a hold of this fella Winslow and have him up here for a nice, friendly chat. A nice, friendly chat.
A nice, friendly chat? That's what I asked you up here for, mister. A nice, friendly chat.
Now, don't you raise your voice at me again.
Now, see here, mister. You done deserted this woman 15 years ago. And she done had you declared legally dead. And there ain't no way that you can legally touch this woman's money.
I don't care about that. I got a pretty good nuisance value in this setup.
What do you mean?
Ah, listen, I don't give that for my ex-wife. All I'm interested in is money. Now, if this fella Brown was to come up with say, $1,000, I'll go town you won't hear from me again.
Now, wait a minute. $1,000? Well, that's out the question.
Listen, all I got to do is show my face, and Brown's chances go down the drain.
Oh, well, now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'll put the proposition up to my client.
All right. I'll give you till tomorrow noon. I goes up and has a talk with him. And that's $1,000 cash. You understand?
Yes, sir. In the future, I'm going to have to start wearing bow ties.
$96, $97, $99, $99, $99, $50, $99, $60, $70, $85, $90, $1,000. And there you is, son, a nickel left over for you to go on your honeymoon.
Yeah, we done borrowed from every fund in the lodge hall, but we done made it.
Well, I'll get this over to Winslow. But the first thing we do when we get the widow's money is put this back.
Yeah, we can't ship the brothers.
I'll say, Andy, and if any of the brothers should happen to kick the bucket, we got to keep them on ice till after the wedding.
Yeah.
Well, Andy, it's 11:50. Any minute, they'll start the death march now. I tell you, son, this is the slickest thing we done ever pulled.
Oh, yeah. 10 minutes from now, our promise is to love, honor, and obey $20,000.
Oh, yeah. I hope he wakes out, and you're going to be happy anyway, Andy.
Yeah. 10 to 12, all right. I guess by now, Mrs. Winslow has arrived here at the church. We sure put one over on that husband of hers. Getting him out of town was one of the smartest things we ever did.
96, 97, 98, 99, $1,000. We sure put one over on that Andrew Brown.
Betty, Tom, having you posed as my missing husband is the best racket we ever thought of.